2535 is our number here if you'd like to talk to Terry Hill. So, Terry, you said school board members have not been responsive. That may not be an accurate quote, but delve into that a little bit. What do you mean by not being responsive, and how would you be?
Hubert, about 2 years ago, parents and educators started talking to our school board about things that were happening within our school system.
Okay.
We were not talking to each other. The breakdown in communication from the school board to the superintendent to central office, all the way down into the classroom, the kids in the classroom, which is really what this is all about anyway. And people tried to talk to our leaders about some things that weren't working, some things that didn't quite make sense, that in fact, as a school board, we did have the ability to make some change on. This has nothing to do with higher expectations or high standards, because we all want that. I mean, there is not a person around that is not going to want the very best for our kids in our schools. But it was the way a lot of this implementation was occurring that just was not matching up. And teachers were seeing this, and they came and they were bringing these issues. Well, they were not being responded to. Parents would call. They were not being responded to. And it just reached the point where and I know you have been following the issues with the board, that it really last fall just kind of all blew up.
Some might say a fever pitch.
Yes, very much a fevered pitch. Yeah. Let me stress, I am not a negative person. I am not one that wants to come in and just change everything top to bottom. I do think, though, that there's a lot of room for improvement. I do think that the time has come for a board member to act as a board member, and that is to supervise the one employee that they have, which is our superintendent, Dr. McIntyre. I think Dr. McIntyre is a fine man. I think he has tried very hard to make the right decisions for Knox County Schools. I just don't agree with a lot of the implementation that has occurred. And these are things that can be fixed. They can be changed. They can be made better. And that is my goal.
974-2535. We're talking with Terry Hill, who is a candidate for 6th District School Board. Since you opened the doors, the attorney said, let's walk into it a little bit. Had you been on the school board at the time, would you have voted for the extension of Dr. McIntyre's contract?
Had I been on the school board in December, my first motion would have been to postpone the vote. Hubert, this is not a vote that needed to happen. It did not need to be brought before the board. There was no legal mandate that this occur. It occurred right after. It was very clear that there was a lot of confusion and unhappiness in the school. My motion would have been to postpone this vote, because I wanted to see if our school board and our superintendent, in fact, would respond and would listen to some of the issues that have been brought up. Now, I'm not naive to the process, and I do know that probably that motion would have failed. Had that motion failed, I would not have voted to extend his contract. Many people thought this was a vote to fire the superintendent. In fact, it was not. Our superintendent already had almost 3 years left on a contract. This was adding a fourth year to it, and I just felt that no one in our school system has a guarantee of future employment for 4 years, and that it was not a good, insightful move to be made.
Toss-up question for you. Common Core.
I absolutely support a high national standard. I think it is important that the United States of America excel and be at the top in globally in education. Common Core, I do recognize, was an attempt to do this. The issues with Common Core are that